Family engagement and research is a new way of doing research that patients and families are involved in all aspects of the research project, right from the point of identifying the research question, what matters to children and their families. This is about bringing daily life of children with disabilities and their families into the research world and into research projects, both at a micro and a macro level.
My older two are neurotypical. Our younger two, though, have definitely challenged our perception of what it means to be in this world. Both of them were born with a number of concerns. We call them physical anomalies. I don't think we imagined what that meant in terms of how we would care for them and what life would look like for us as a family. So taking the Family Engagement and Research course was just such a fun thing to do. That was such a gift. The gift of connection is something I don't think we can even put a value to.
The engagement as being discovered in many places of the world is something fundamental to do meaningful research. And we are noticing now that there is a huge gap in understanding around the world of how this can be delivered in a meaningful way and in a way that people are really prepared to work together.
We have worked in collaboration with Kids Brain Health Network, CanChild, and McMaster University Center for Continuing Education to build this program and grow it from the very beginning. We've designed the course that families and researchers are put into small groups, and they work together on a project over the 10 weeks. And so they're not only just learning about the theory of family engagement and research, but they're actually able to practice family engagement research on this project. And what we've heard from graduates is that's the most meaningful part of the course, because at the end of the course, they're leaving with knowledge and skills in family engagement research.
This has been a real watershed moment for researchers. We got together, Dr. Andrea Cross, Connie Putterman, and myself. The three of us sat down and said, we need a program, half for researchers, half for parents, but we need to have people learning together so that there's no power imbalance, we get to know each other, we get to trust each other.
When it comes to this connection piece and the opportunity you have within the training program to build relationships, it becomes sort of a judgment-free space for people to better understand what it means to build those honest connections along the way and to not do that in isolation as well too. And so you have this broader community where you can share and exchange different ideas.
I think what I became most passionate about after taking this course is really the involvement of diverse perspectives, and diversity comes in many shapes and forms. It could be people with different abilities, people with different academic or research backgrounds, people with different lived experience, and just the incorporation of diversity in your research program in whatever shape or form. And I try to incorporate that as much as I can in my own area of research.
I'm a parent of three children, two of which have significant special needs. I saw a need for the parent voice. A lot of times when we talk about medical professionals, they have the best of intentions and they have the knowledge and they have the theories and the applicability, but they don't actually know what life is like in the trenches. The FER course, it really helped me learn to be stable in my situation as a research parent partner. And that was something I'll internally be grateful for.
I think there is a change happening and underway where researchers and academics particularly are understanding that they need to involve people with lived experience in what they do, not just because it's a nice thing to do, but actually because it increases the amount of innovation and impact that their initiatives have.
It's just been a phenomenal relationship. Kids Brain Health Network has listened to what we were saying, and they actually supported us and have those shared values. And they really talk the talk, and they really value families to be involved in the conversations.
We are in the process of dreaming up ways to make these programs scalable out to the world, out to other domains, adult disability, other disease groups. It's an approach that could work in many domains of healthcare.